Recording in progress.
I'm done, can't stand. You gotta feel no hope. You gotta feel no hope. Oh, things eternal. But you gotta hold on. To get the changing hand. You gotta hold on. I'm changing hand. You got to hold on.
What's your impossible? I need a miracle. What's got you barely hanging by a single thread? What looks so hopeless now? What weighs down your heart with doubt? You beg for a breakthrough, but no sign of breakthrough yet. When you've cried and you've cried till your tears run dry, the answer won't come and you don't know why. And you wonder if you can bow your head even one more time. Don't stop praying. Don't stop calling on Jesus' name. Keep on pounding on heaven's door. Let your knees wear out the floor. Don't stop believing. 'Cause mountains move with just a little faith. And your Father's heard every single word you're saying. So don't stop praying. He's close to the brokenhearted. It saves those who are crushed in spirit. The Alpha and Omega knows how your story ends. When you've cried and you've cried till your tears run dry, the answer won't come and you don't know why. And you wonder if you can bow your head even one more time. Oh, do it one more time. And don't stop praying. Your knees wear out the floor. Don't stop believing. 'Cause mountains move with just a little faith. And your Father's heard every single word you're saying. So don't stop praying.
Don't stop.
Oh, don't stop praying.
Don't stop praying.
Don't stop praying for the miracle. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Well, don't stop praying that addictions end. Don't stop praying for deliverance. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Oh, don't stop praying for the sickness healed. Don't stop praying for His power revealed. Name, keep on pounding on heaven's door. Let your knees wear out the floor. Don't stop believing. 'Cause mountains move with just a little faith. And your Father's heard every single word you're saying. So don't stop praying.
Don't stop praying.
Don't you give up.
I can't think of a better way to start than just a reminder, maybe a bit of encouragement for us. Don't stop praying. Sometimes there are songs that just have the right words for the right moment. And so just before we get into this week's prayer, I just want to, for whoever needs it, maybe it's myself, so just don't stop praying no matter what it is that you're going through. Even if you're like, about to give up. You know, I've been praying for this thing. I've been asking God for whatever. Don't stop. Don't stop praying. It actually builds up your faith. But, you know, God does actually answer prayers. And sometimes the response and the answers come back into a specific time. So sometimes you prayed and he's answered you and it's just not the right time for a certain thing, or he's removed something from you that he has greater things for you and he didn't want you to stumble. So don't stop praying and don't lose hope in prayer if you're not seeing what you believe the answer is. So I thank you, Lord, that you're just reminding us that as we are a prayer ministry, this is what we are about. But we're not only coming to pray to you for things, though we stand in deep valleys, many of us, and we stand with wants and needs, but just reminding us, Lord God, that prayer is how we communicate with you. It is a two-way. So as we lift up our prayers this morning, I stand believing that you are also answering, meaning we have time. We're putting time on the clock to hear from you, to sit still in your presence so we can hear you speak to us. I ask, Lord God, that you will just bless us with your presence this morning, as I know you are already here. But Lord, glorify yourself through me so that they will see you and not me. Demonstrate the power of the Holy Spirit through me so that they will know that you are real and you are true. And for those who are in a season of doubt, Lord God, those who are just ready to give up praying, Lord God, because they're not seeing the answers in their timeline. They're not seeing the answers accelerated according to their mind and their thinking, that you'll just remind us, Lord God, your ways are not our ways, but that doesn't cause us to stop praying. So I thank you, Lord, that you have set this altar before us and before you, that because of the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, we have access to heaven. And because of what Jesus Christ has done on our behalf, we are seated in heavenly places. And because of what your word says, Lord God, that you are a great God, a great creator, that you will never leave us nor forsake us. Because of what you have written and as it is written, we have access to your throne. Even as prodigal sons and daughters, you still call us back to you. Because of your great grace and your mercy, because of your loving kindness, because of your faithfulness, we have access to your throne. And so as we're standing now in those heavenly places and our environment has even shifted, I ask that you will open this portal gate to heaven, so that as we pray, Lord God, these prayers are lifted as incense in heaven, that your holy angel warriors are fighting for us and protecting us even while we're praying, that you're releasing even the answers that we need even while we're praying. So Lord God, the seeds of doubt and the seeds of chaos and any seed, Lord God, that has been planted by the enemy even overnight in our thoughts and in our situations, that anything that has caused us to be separated from believing in you and your faithfulness, Lord God, it is removed right now because of what your word says. Father, if we have done anything that separated us from you, anything that we have done, anything that we have touched or spoken, anything that we have read or listened to, anything that have caused us to be separated from you in any way, Father, we want what you have for us. So Lord, we ask for your holy forgiveness this morning before we even go into prayer. And we thank you, Lord God, for giving us this opportunity to come before your holy throne. I thank you for what you are releasing this morning and this Monday. I thank you for the blessings to come and the blessings to Kirishima'ira. Blessings that have already happened. Amen. And Father, I ask that you will undo anything that we have bound ourselves to that was not from you. Any lie, any seed, anything, any incantation, anything the enemy has planted that we have swallowed up as if it was you. Father, we want to be the one that you chase after, not the 99. So set us apart from the world, Lord God. Father, as the world is crying out, where is love? Where is joy? Where is peace? That we are love and we are joy and we are peace. That we are the blessing, we are the breakthrough in our families and on our jobs. Father, let this be a very special and different day, Lord God, as we enter into this Monday, July 15th. Let there be such a turnaround for those who are still looking for an answer, those who are on the verge of giving up, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And we didn't even get started yet. Amen. I thank you, Lord, for this Monday. I am already filled up. I thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do today, Lord God. I thank you for blessing us and bringing us here. Thank you that you have shown me that this is a month of breakthrough for those who want it. Amen. Amen. So now we're going straight into confession. I'm sorry. Hold on, y'all. Today is called taking action, taking action, taking action. So the verse says, continuously, continue steadfastly in prayer, being watchful in it with thanksgiving. And so again, we're just going to spend a minute just to thank God for where we are right now. And for those of you, as you are thanking God out of your mouth, as you are thanking God for where you are right now, it says, you know, continue to pray, but also being watchful, you know, watching for the answers and then greeting it with thanksgiving. Go ahead and release that. I'm going to release a prayer again over all of us. So Father, as they are thanking you right now, I thank you, Lord, that every one of us that represented here, families, Lord God, even the people who are watching the replay, that you will even remind them that in response to a prayer is thanksgiving. When prayers go up, we receive the responses through thanksgiving. It seals our faith. It shows that we believe that you are responding and you are answering. We give you praise and thanksgiving, Lord God, as we continue to seek your face in prayer. We give you thanksgiving. We thank you for answering. I thank you in advance because I know you have answered these prayers. I thank you that everything that they stand in need of, they have asked for, that you have already said yes, Lord God, and that you are sending the answers to them in different form. Now, Lord, I ask that you make it very plain as they are watching for your answers through job interviews, as they are watching for the answers through ministries, as they are watching through the answers, Lord God, through interactions with family and friends, Lord God, as if they're waiting for health reports, that even so it is. Thank you, Lord. We give you thanks and praise, Lord God, for what you have done for us. You have saved us time and time again from things seen and unseen. I thank you, Lord God, that you have fought for us. You have brought us to another day. We are still alive, and so we give you all glory and praise. Lord, we thank you for breath. We thank you for these limbs we have. We thank you for sight. We thank you for this altar of prayer that is before your holy throne. We thank you, Lord God, you have blessed us, that you have seen about your sons and daughters. I thank you, Lord God, because it is only because of your mercy, nothing that we have done to deserve this. I thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for who you are in our life. I thank you, Holy Spirit, for continuing to lead, guide, and support us. We thank you, Lord, for this day. Amen. Now we go into confession again. Confession is for us. we don't even have a right to the throne that we're bellying up to. And yet here we are because of what God has done. So now we confess because it puts us in a heart posture to remember that we don't deserve this. It is only because of what God has done. The Lord Jesus Christ has done. The Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty God, we acknowledge and confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. Deep within us our sorrow for the wrong we have done and the good we have left undone. Lord, you are full of compassion and gracious. You're slow to anger. You're plenteous in mercy. There is always forgiveness with you. Restore to us the joy of your salvation. Bind up that which is broken. Give light to our minds, strength to our wills, and rest to our souls. Speak to each of us and let your word abide with us until it has wrought in us your holy will. Amen. Father, as we have released this confession, we believe that your word says that there is no condemnation in Christ. And so we also bind any voice, anything that has been speaking to us and telling us that we have no value in your court, anything that has been telling us that we don't have the right title to serve, anything that has tried to separate us from your holy kingdom, we bind that up now. And as it is bound, Lord God, as it is bound in the unseen place, it is bound here on earth so that we can do the work that you have called us to do, so that we can actually take action in this place. Amen. 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 We're going to go into Luke 9, but before we do this, I'm going to be obedient. Psalm 116, and I'm just going to release it for the person on the replay who's going to need this. So Psalm 116, I'm reading, this is the ESV version. This is a psalm that you can go to when you're saying, I'm not sure what to give thanks for because I'm in this season and I don't feel like God's answering my prayer. This is for you, okay? This is a scripture that I release when I'm in that, I don't know what to pray for because I'm not feeling it, okay? So the word says, I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my pleas for mercy, because he inclined his ear to me. Therefore, I will call on him as long as I live. The snares of death encompassed me. The pangs of Sheol laid hold on me. I suffered distress and anguish. Then I called on the name of the Lord. Oh, Lord, I pray, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is merciful. The Lord preserves the simple. When I was brought low, he saved me. Return, O my soul, to your rest, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with you. For you have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. It goes on in verse 14. It says, I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. It also says it in verse 18, I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. And it ends with praise the Lord. So I'm releasing this for the person who's going to need this. Again, there's not, I don't believe in coincidences. And whenever the Lord is showing me certain things, I'm going to be obedient to it. So we started out the song again. The song is not our own, but we started out the song that we played. Don't stop praying. Don't stop believing. Don't give up. And again, go into Psalm 116. But when it says, I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all the people, it just showed me how this ties back into what we're doing. We're talking about taking action. So God has delivered us all, every one of us, out of some things that we don't even understand, okay? And now we pay our vows to him in the presence of his people. So you're required to do something. So Luke 9, 1 through 6, this is when Jesus sent out the 12 apostles. And the word says he called them together. I'm going to contextualize it, my words, and gave them power and authority over all demons to cure diseases. So the first thing you got to understand as we're walking into breakthrough month this week, and we're talking about taking action, that you actually got to do something. A lot of times we pray and we pray for God to give us our daily needs, right? Food, rent, bills, health, our daily needs, jobs, family, all those things, daily needs. But what I want us to do is to start pulling on the greater needs for the jobs that we need to do, heavenly kingdom work, right? So we're looking for breakthrough in that area. Remember, I keep saying it's not about breakthrough just for material things. We're talking about breakthrough in kingdom work, in spiritual matters, amen? But the first thing I want you to see is that when Jesus called the people together, the apostles together, he gave them power and authority. That power and authority didn't come from your church, your pastor, your bishop, or your apostle. This power and authority I'm talking about can only come from the Lord Jesus Christ. When I released the word and I said, glorify yourself through me, Lord God, right? It's him doing it, right? Demonstrate your power and authority. That's the Holy Spirit doing it through us. But you've got to go do something. He has to give you the power and authority. Otherwise, you go out, a lot of you guys go out and you go out in judgment. You go out, you'll be on social media talking about what people wear, and that's judgment. That's not power or authority, okay? It says in verse 2, it says, he sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal. So again, there's a reason that God is sending us out in this season, in this breakthrough season. He's sending us out to proclaim the kingdom of God, one, and to heal, two. And he said to them, take nothing for your journey. Now it goes on and explains, don't take your staff, don't take your bread. I'll even say it's not written here, but don't take your judgment. Don't take your baggage. don't take your mindset. Don't take the things from the old you into what you're doing in this new season. Don't bring that into where you're going. My ears are ringing. Oh my God. Don't do that, right? When it says they departed and went through the village, they were preaching the gospel and they were healing everywhere. So the same way we ask God to give us breakthrough, we need to be the breakthrough and the blessing where he places us. So in your family, you're the breakthrough. In your family, you're the blessing. That's you. This is our dominion, and he gives us power and authority to operate in this area where we are, preaching the gospel and healing. So healing could be healing words. It could be, the way that we interact with each other. We're not breaking people down. We're not judging them. All of these things. So I just want to call this out to you that as he sends us out, and we are, the power and authority is coming from the Holy Spirit. as you go out into wherever you go out into your day, whatever you, whenever you in your, you might interact with somebody on the, listen, all of us have people we work with that we'd rather not work with, if you know what I mean, you know? But even then, even so, you're required to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal. Amen. So this ain't gonna be, you send in a seed and you send in a seed and I tell you how to get blessed in 30 days. This is breakthrough from your heart. This is God working through you. James 1, 22 through 23, this is the first scripture we're gonna pray through. It says, be doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving yourself. Because a lot of people will read scripture, they hear, but they deceive themselves. Right? They hear, they pull one piece down and without God giving you revelation, you'll deceive yourself. For if anyone is a hearer and not a doer, he's like a man who looks intently at his natural face in a mirror. Okay. So the first thing we're going to pray is, Lord, I want to be a doer of your word. I don't want to deceive myself. Lord, I want to be a doer of your word. So that's the first prayer that we're going to release. So go ahead and release this. As you're praying this for yourself out loud, I'm going to cover you guys in prayer. Amen. And pray for those who are watching the replay, especially, I don't know who you are, but you need to know that, oh God, the God of all God is still blessing you. He's still protecting you. He still loves you. And it is not a church hurt situation. This is a heart posture that you were sent in to do. You were sent in to proclaim the kingdom of God and heal, and yet you went in through judgment. So now I'm asking God to bless you and forgive you for what you have done. And as you have centered your heart on turning things around, now be a doer of his word. Love, joy, and peace. I pray, God, that you'll show them how to live out love, joy, and peace, the fruits of the Spirit, Lord God, that can only be done through the power and authority that is in us through the Holy Spirit. So, Lord, we surrender ourselves so that we can be doers of your word. Lord God, we're looking around for man to save us. Many of us are looking around for the teachers to help and the pastors to help and the government to help. But, Lord, it is you. You have sent us. We are the ones being sent out in the same way that you anointed and sent out your apostles, the same way that you sent them out is the same that we are being sent out to do something in this land. So Lord, I pray that we will be the doers of the word, that we will bring the word to life, not through judgment, but through love. And Lord, I even ask that those who are going out and speaking, Lord God, or doing or taking action, Lord God, that it truly comes from a place of love and humility and forgiveness, Lord, that it really is because of the fruit of the Spirit living in us. When people ask to see the seed, that they will look on our lives, Lord God, and they will see the fruits of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, as the seed in our life. They will see it. They will see that is the fruit, Lord God, so that when we go out into this world today and we go out in our jobs and in our families, that we're not operating from judgment, Lord God. If it is so, Lord God, if that's what they are doing, I ask that you will bind up their lips so they do nothing to curse your children, because all of us were created by you. So Lord, I even send right now for those who are standing in error, those who are going out in judgment, those who are using and twisting your words, Lord God, anyone who has said anything that is counter to your word, that you will bind them up in spirit, Lord God, so that they cause no more destruction. And those you have sent, Lord God, to bring healing, to be the light, to be your hands and feet in this world, Lord God, that we will be filled as doers, Lord God, that you will protect us. I thank you, Lord, that you have already sent heaven to help us alongside, that we're not doing this by ourselves. I thank you for the warrior forces, the angels that you have sent, Lord God, to be alongside us, to be with us in travel as we're on the roads today, going to and from our destination. Oh God, I even thank you as we're standing in our kitchen making coffee, that I thank you for that. I thank you for giving us the energy and the strength to carry out the tasks that you have given us. Lord, we want to be doers of your word. Father, those who need to understand what specifically you have called them to do, I ask you to reveal to them through scripture what it is that you have assigned for them so they can complete the task. Thank you, Lord. You have already given us everything that we need and that you will confirm for those who are standing and waiting for a confirmation. Stop waiting. Stop waiting, Karen. I don't know if you're on here and I'm just watching you running through your house and serving a bunch of people and having events. Stop waiting. Thank you, Jesus. Even the things in your in-home prayers, stop waiting. Do something. Be doers of the word. Amen. Colossians 3, 23, 24 says, whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men. You see, this is another thing that we get a little bit confused, especially when we're working for people, Lord, we don't really genuinely care for, that we're working for you. But even as we are doing that, we have to submit our heart under that authority. Amen. So as we're praying this right now, knowing that from the Lord, you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Jesus Christ because we have been sent out, because we are working for the kingdom of God, because we have a different leader. Your manager is the Lord Jesus Christ, because our inheritance is our reward, that we are working and serving those around us. So Father, I pray this over yourself, Lord God, Lord, that you'll just remind me that I'm doing this for you, Lord God, and my inheritance comes from you, that everything that I do, I'm doing because I'm serving you. Because I'm serving you, Lord God, every single thing that I do it through love, through patience, through humility, through the fruits of the Spirit. Father, I thank you that the Holy Spirit is working through us so we can carry these things out, because we can't do this by ourselves. So, Lord, I thank you for blessing us. I thank you for rewarding us. I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you, Lord, we know that our inheritance comes from you. I thank you that as we are serving you, Lord God, that we're a blessing to those around us, even the ones that we are naturally against, these foes and these enemies on the jobs, even that, Lord God, I ask for humility in our own hearts so that we can represent you, Lord God. Father, this is so hard for us in the natural. Oh, but it is so much lighter in the spirit if you let the Holy Spirit go before you. Amen. If you let him fight your battles for you, you have nothing to worry about. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that those who are seeking this season to do more for you, Lord God, that you'll even present opportunities in ways for them to serve, Lord God. Will you open the doors for them so that they can serve? Maybe it's a one-to-one. Maybe it's a one-to-many. Maybe it's a one-to-many. Millions, whatever it is, those who are standing in and waiting for an opportunity to serve you, will you let that show up and give them the grace to serve and the humility and the humbleness to serve you, so we can be the light. We represent you, Lord God, in everything we do today. Amen. 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 All right. So this is where, again, open up and ask God for whatever you want. We thank you, Lord. And as you're praying for whatever you stand in need, the word says in Matthew 21, 22, whatever you ask in prayer, you'll receive it if you have faith. And as you're praying, I'm going to cover you back here. Amen. And everything that they're asking, Lord God, everything that they are presenting before your throne, everything that they're presenting on the altar, we're placing it on the altar and we're giving it over to you. Everything related to every family connected on this call this morning and every person in our prayer ministry, every single one of them, Lord God, whatever they're asking for in prayer, we're presenting it now to you on your altar. Now, Abba, I know that you will bless us in the way that you see the right way to go for us. We don't want to supersede what your will is for us. We want to be in alignment with your will and your time. Lord, the word says all things are working together for our good for those who serve the Lord. So as we are seeking you out this morning, I pray, Lord, that all things are now working together for our good. Father, I ask that for those who are stuck in a timeline of yesterday, that you will even accelerate time for them. Lord, would you drop them in the timeline they should be in so they can hear directly from you. I thank you, Lord God, they're spinning clocks. Father, I thank you that there is no one who is outside of your will and on this call. There's no one who is outside of your will in our ministry. There is no one, Lord God, that we are aligned with you, that we are in alignment with you, that we are on the right time. We are in the right place at the right time, that we're going to get the blessings that we are praying for, asking you for in the right time. I thank you that this is the opportune time, Lord God, for visions that people have had to come through. I thank you, Jesus, that this is breakthrough season for every person under the sound of my voice, that they are stepping into the right time. I thank you that this is the right time for a breakthrough for job search, that this is the right time for a breakthrough for healing. This is the right time for a breakthrough for ministry, for those who are seeking ways to minister to others, one-to-one or one-to-many. I thank you, Lord God, that this is a breakthrough in our mindset. This is the right time for that. This is a right time. I thank you, Lord God, that the ideas and anything that you put in us, that we have brought that to completion, that you will reveal to us who we are is the way that heaven sees us, not the way that others see us. Why? Because we need to build up our confidence in Christ. You see, we, Father, the word tells us that we are the head and not the tail, but most of us don't truly believe that. The word tells us so many things about you being faithful, you being just, and causing calling us to be obedient to you, but many of us just don't believe that. The word tells us that the greatest of these is love, but most of us won't even do that. So Lord, let there be a breakthrough in our prayer lives, in our spiritual walk, so that we can be in alignment with what your word says concerning us, so that we're not just reading the word, but we're doers of it, that everything that we touch, what we produce is aligned with the fruit of the Spirit. Holy Spirit, I ask that you will flood us, Lord, that you'll go ahead of us, behind us, beside us, next to us, and around us, that you'll cover us under the presence of God as we go everywhere this week. Lord, that you'll just cover us like a cloak. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That is your power and your authority that gives us what we need to do, what we got to do on this earth plane. So Holy Spirit, I ask that you will overtake us. And for those who have not been filled by you, those who have not experienced you as a person, those who are still thinking that you're you're not real. They don't understand that relationship. Oh, Holy Spirit, would you make this a different day? Make this a different Monday. Would you cause them to experience you in real? Would you show up to them in real in your presence? Would you bring that, bring all of your fruits, everything, and demonstrate your power through us? We are your vessels, Lord God. So Lord, all of these things we ask, we seek you first. We seek you first in everything we do. And all of these things, we know that you're going to bless us with everything that we stand in need of. If we focus on you, you take care of everything else. So we keep our eyes on you, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Y'all still there?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
All right. So now go to them. Don't be quiet. I'll just keep taking all his grace. Okay. I'm greedy that way. I'll just keep taking it for myself. All right. So I declare this day that no weapon formed against me can prosper, because I am the righteousness of God. Favor surrounds me as a shield. Divine protection surrounds me as a shield. I am therefore in the right place.
I am therefore in the right place.
I cannot be defeated or destroyed.
I cannot be defeated.
Every tongue that accuses me, every tongue that attacks me, I condemn with my words. This is my heritage. This is my right as a child of God. I'm made in his image. I'm made in his dominion and authority, living in me, coming forth out of my spirit, my word. I declare today that Satan has no power over my life.
I declare today
every weapon he has been defeated, that fear has been cast out, that love makes my strength, for I cannot fail.
Makes my faith.
Cannot fail. And that's what I'm made of. Word. Made in his image. After his likeness. With the power of the Holy Spirit and authority of his word.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, by the blood of Jesus, I dwell in the secret place of the Most High. I abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I say of the Lord, you are my refuge and my fortress. My God, in you I will trust. Father, I thank you for this declaration. It doesn't matter how many times I say it, I speak differently, Holy Spirit. And I thank you for revealing these are the words that you say concerning us. Now, Lord, when you gave me this word so many years ago, I didn't really understand why I needed to keep this declaration until it was released to others this year. But I thank you, Lord, for what you have done, because even now I understand your timing. You see, for somebody who is listening, you think God forgot you because your assignment has been on hold, that you've been waiting for something for years. Can I tell you, I was undercover for 20-something years, amen, until it it was his time to move me into a different place in his kingdom, to do his work. I needed to be under his refuge for quite some time so he could refine me, so he could reform my mind, so he could renew my thinking. But he gave me these words so that I could speak things according to what he says about me. You see, it could have just been a Proverbs 31 scripture here, but that wasn't true about what he had for me and what he has for you. This is different. This is when we declare, we're letting the enemy know who we are and whose we are, not just the things that we can accomplish. Some of us are fighting different battles. That's why that's why he wants you not to give up hope in your prayer life. That's why he wants you to keep praying, because some of us are fighting not just for ourselves, but for families and for generations coming behind us. Amen. So when the word starts out in scripture, where it talks about no weapon formed against you, you've got to have that. You've got to believe that in your spirit. You got to believe it in your mind. When you understand that divine protection surrounds you as a shield, then you don't have to suffer from self-doubt anymore. When you understand that you're in the right place at the right time, you don't have envy or jealousy, because you know that God, what God has for you is for you, and he's going to put you where you need to be at the right time. When the word says that you can't be defeated or destroyed, that's what the word says concerning you. So any gossip or any envy or anything that's going to come for you, and it will come from friends, and it will come from family, and it will come from strangers, because of the walk that you have to carry out, you've got to just deal with that. Just know that they can't condemn you. You are still protected. Satan has no power over your life. He's going to use some weapon, but he's still going to be defeated. So don't let fear hold you back, because love is going to make your faith and belief work. It is love, not judgment. The word says God's word can't fail, and that's what you're made of. We're made up of his word, Jesus Christ. We're made in his image, after his likeness. How? And we're with the power of the Holy Spirit, the authority of his words. I love this declaration, Lord God, because now I can see it coming into fruition in other people's lives around me. I thank you for the many who have spoken and released these words, Lord God, that they have become more like you, that they are transformed and they are renewed, Lord God, that their breakthrough this month is really just a transformation, their completed transformation, in this here month, the number 7, completion. I pray that your breakthrough this month is a completed transformation into his likeness, that you're more like him, that you're filled up with the power of the Holy Spirit, that you understand the authority of your words, that you will seek him, you will dwell in his secret place. It's not your closet, it's your heart. Amen. That's why it's so important that heart posture comes back again. He's seeking your heart. Your secret place is your heart, because everything comes from there. What's really in your heart comes out through your mind, comes out through your mouth, it comes out through your actions, it helps you do what you do. So I thank you, Lord, that you are the dwelling place for us, and as you are in us, we are in you. Amen. I thank you, Lord God, that this is a breakthrough season for all of us, that we are being drawn closer to you, Lord God. You are our fortress. We put all our trust in you, God. Everything on the table, we put all our trust and belief in what you say concerning every situation in our lives, that we won't have lack. Lord God, I thank you, Lord God. I thank you for what you have done in your revelation. I pray that it will open up the minds, Lord God, of the people around me, Lord God, that they will be blessed and they will come to see you in the way I see you. Nothing but Abba, gracious Father, God of all, creator of all, Lord Jesus Christ, my true Savior, my salvation, Holy Spirit, my bestie, my best friend, my guider, my kiresidisa, yo solo oma asa, e grashatra, Adonai, my great Father. Oh, thank you for filling me up this morning with just a reminder, Lord God, that what we declare, what we say over ourselves, it will come true, because we can create with our mouth. So Lord, even seal our mouth, Lord God, seal our mouths so we don't even say anything to destroy. We don't use our own words to condemn ourselves or our families. Lord, as we're taking action this week, as we're going into different places and spaces, Lord God, that our words, every word that we speak has to be aligned back to what you say. And I pray that everything, every action we take this week will be filled with love, joy, and peace. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Again, this, you know, as of last week, you know, this is what he showed me. So I'm going to be obedient. And this was a prayer that for those, because we have a lot of people who watch the replay who might not be, you know, maybe they're ready to give their lives to Christ, or we have some people who just want to reaffirm or, you know, reconfirm their relationship with Jesus. So this is a simple prayer. And again, if you want to be, if you'd like to be born again and want to come into this family, y'all don't, you know, there's no seed needed. This is just your heart posture to the Lord. And it's a very simple prayer. And this prayer is, Lord Jesus, I believe you're the Son of God, that you died on the cross to rescue me from sin and death and to restore me to the Father. I choose now to turn from my sins, my self-centeredness, and every part of my life that does not please you. I choose you. I give myself to you. I receive your forgiveness and ask you to take your rightful place in my life as my Savior and Lord. Come reign in my heart. Fill me with your love and your life. Restore me, Jesus. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. It is a very simple prayer. And if you have prayed this, Lord, I ask that you will now reveal yourself unto them. Lord, you will show them, you know, where to go to worship a Bible-based church, that you will surround them with good, solid, you know, people, brothers and sisters to help them along their journey, and that you will bless them with it, and that you will demonstrate your power through love in their lives. And you will transform any person who has said this prayer, Lord God, and really meant it, that they will be transformed in their hearts and in their minds and in their souls. We thank you, Lord, for giving us the opportunity to even come and enter into prayer with you. It is nothing but the blood that has done this for us. Amen. Amen. All right, now we go into benediction. Ephesians 3:20, it says, now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. 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 All right. I'm going to stop sharing. And for those of y'all who watch, we always stop sharing the live so we can have fellowship. You're welcome to join. By the way, we have dropped the phone number so that if you can't dial into Zoom or you can't catch us on live stream, then you can call in. Now, we're giving you a lot of opportunities, making it as simple as possible, but it's a two-way. You've got to tap in. All right. All right, so I love y'all, but Jesus loves you more, and I'm going to stop the recording.